Right, folks, and welcome to another video. It's episode 102 of the 10-Minute Modeling Challenge. Can you believe it? Two consecutive weeks now. Surprise, surprise. Really sense. I don't know, but I'm back now anyway. And yesterday I released a long video about how to do low poly modeling in Blender, especially low poly characters that we cloned and made some copies of into different variations. And we animated it and exported it into Unity and Mix Ammo and things like that. So check that video out if you haven't seen it before. I turned one character into about 100 of them, and that was a lot of fun. So I've shared that with a lot of my patrons. You can download those, so you should be able to have a lot of fun. So thanks again to all my patrons, of course, and thanks to everyone who's watching and subscribing. So feels nice to be doing these little intros again, and maybe next week I'll get a haircut. What's left of it, I'm going to try to deal with, because I haven't cut my hair since I got here 8 months ago. Starting to go a little bit wild and crazy. It feels like feel like Donald Trump or something. Feels like windy on Karlfjellet in Swedish. Vines on the sand dunes. I don't know what you want to call it. But anyway, earlier today I looked into the Discord, of course, and Arvid there does a tremendous job. He's running the weekly Discord modeling challenge in the Infancia Discord server. I don't even know what it's called, really. It's called the weekly modeling challenge, I think. And we need to get some more people modeling there. I think some people have dropped off, lost track of the ball like I did, dropped the ball, couldn't find it. But we're working ourselves back now into fashion, right? So you want to start modeling again. And what better way to do it than to jump over to the Infancia Discord server, link in the description, and then start modeling whatever is on the theme there. Share your items, what you're doing. I'm going to go through all of them. I've got a backlog of about a year that I'm going to go through. But it's not about the backlog. It's not about the judgment. It is about participating and doing your thing. Because if you model stuff and practice, you'll become better. And I need to practice again because I had a bit of a break. Back now, and so I'm gonna jump onto that bandwagon. I don't want to fall off here, so I'm gonna jump on it. And this week's theme is kitchen and kitchen appliances. I thought, well, I can do some low poly kitchen appliances. And then following up, it's been a lot of talk about AI lately, hasn't it? And AI ripping off artists and stuff like that. And I don't really know what to think about that. And to stay educated, I had to jump in and try AI generated art myself. And I thought, okay, I'll start with a robot or something. So I searched for, I put some key terms in, searched, I put Optimus Prime, cool, mech, robot, warrior, awesome, hero, epic, all those cool search terms. And it did a pretty good job, actually. I generated a few of them, and to my surprise, it looks pretty good. I don't know how ripped that off or anything like that is. It's probably, the source images probably come from somewhere. So I'm gonna have to try to get myself a little bit educated on this now. And then I thought, okay, can I turn Optimus Prime now into something that looks a little bit more like the weekly challenge? But it turns out that the computer struggles a little bit when he can't really follow simple instructions. Because I said, make Optimus Prime or something like that, a mech warrior, mock Optimus Prime out of kitchen appliances. And I tried 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 and I tried, and it could not quite get there. It started to get the shape of it, and I had to crocodile wrestle it into place. And I said, okay, take that picture that you nearly did there. It looks it looks like a mech warrior, but it doesn't look quite like kitchen appliances. And I kept telling it, put toaster on the legs, put a microwave on the head, do something. And it started to turn vicious on me, and it started to produce images where it started to look a bit scary, as if it was a little bit upset with me. And I kept saying, like, I just want kitchen appliances on your arms, I want a toaster on your head. And the more I said that, the more annoyed with it me got, it seems. So I had to stop in the end, because it started to look like it was going to attack me. And I think I'm just going to have to leave that stuff be for now. And I'll have to stick to my low poly modeling. And that's what we're going to do now. So I'm going to jump into Blender and we're going to get modeling. How fun is that? So I'm going to see what I can do in 10 minutes. I've got my clock here, of course. Well, it's a phone, but I'm going to set my clock on it, as we always do. Well, I didn't do it for a year and a half, but I'm doing it now. So clock, am I recording yet? Because last week I had to do this three times because I forgot to record. Timer, 10 minutes on the clock. Ready, steady, go, start. And we're off. Yes, it is ticking. So shift space G, get this one out. A to select everything, scale, shift Z, and maybe two. We'll make a small kitchen area. Diorama, remember. And then we'll make a cooker. Shift D to duplicate that one, scale it down. E to extrude 0.8 centimeters maybe. Is it that high? Shift space is probably, yeah, I think so. And then shift scale, shift Z. That's the good shape of a cooker. I like it. And then shift D to duplicate this top face, right click, do subdivide, and then we'll go to loop tools, add on, and we'll do circle. This is how we do our circles quicker. L and A on the left side, I've got a spider up there that's flying, so it's not a spider. Unless it's mutated. Shifty, it's the AI spying on me. And S, Shift Z, scale it down a little bit more, and then we'll just copy this one. Shift D to duplicate it, move it to here, and L, we'll just put some. These are old fashioned rings here. Who's still got these things in their kitchen? Is it all induction nowadays, anyway? I guess. So we'll do Control R to. Should I bevel this? Yes, I will. So Control B to bevel that. We'll sleek there, and then now we'll do Control R, loop cut, scale on the. Whoa. Scale on the y-axis, and then Control R, scale on the z-axis, move this up, indent a little bit, extrude inwards, dark thing there. And then here I'm going to do like shift space G. I have to have a handle, right? So scale on the y-axis, there we go, and should I do E to extrude, and I'll try to grab Alt Z so I can see through. Let's grab those two faces and E to extrude that in, and Control R, scale on the y-axis, and Control Alt select, no, on the edge select, Control B to bevel those, and that's gonna happen. Let's put something down here as well. Actually, we have to put like a little vent or something so we get a few more features. Backside I don't really care about, so that's gonna have to. But we can put a little control panel here, should we? So a lot of extra geometry here, but I don't really care about that. How should I do it? Control R, and there we do. I to inset, Alt E to extrude long faces. Down will do, apparently. Okay, that's good. That's our cooker, kitchen cooker. And we have to move it to the side. So Control I to invert the selection and move that one down there. And we'll put a workbench here. I think Shift D to duplicate that face, E to extrude it. Am I back face cooling here? No, I'm not. But now I am, I think. Hope I did that right. We'll put a dark, it's gonna be a modern kitchen, I guess, so put a dark, nice bench here. Scale on the x-axis, and here we go. What should we put here? We'll put some set of drawers here. So Shift D, I'll just duplicate that face, E to extrude, wrong direction, that's the back face culling for you. Go to there, maybe. E to extrude down, move it down to there. Should we do this one in wood? I think so. Or brown, at least. So we'll put some drawers here. Control R. Is it called kitchen drawers? Yeah, I think so. 6:52 on the clock there. Control R. We'll put some nice drawers here. And I to inset twice to get individual. And I guess I'll just do them out or something. Control plus. I can't open these, but that's okay. Do a little bit darker there. That's it. And then what should we put here then? We have to put another one here, so I'll cheat a little bit. Shift D to duplicate there. And we've got a corner here, so we have to figure out how to do there. Shift D to probably come on up. Can't speak now. Hold the control key. So pardon me. I'm a bit rusty with speaking with what I'm actually doing here apparently too. So but Alt Z to see through, and then we'll just grab these. We can't have it incorrectly. We'll have to do a little skinny thing in the corner. And then we'll just extrude this part of the desk. Hold the control key. Actually, I'm gonna switch. Spot the vertex snapping and we can snap that onto there. Hold the control key and snap that onto there. That's good. And the corner is okay like that. And usually you put a little, when you do kitchens like this, you have to put a little thing here to cover it. Usually you end up skipping those things when you actually build your kitchen because you're so fed up with it. You just want to get it finished. But we don't do it. We don't cheat here. We do E to extrude that on. And little corner thing there. Okay, so what more do you have in a kitchen? Well, you have a fridge and a freezer, so we'll put that here. We'll do a nice big stainless steel ones or something. E, 2 meters tall. Big, tall. No, actually, we're gonna go down a little bit. Have to be realistic here. Control R, we'll split that one there. I'm gonna do, we've got actually, for the first time, I have two big separate ones, but I'm gonna do the ones we've actually got here in Australia now. For some reason, we bought the one that's got these little, like a top and a bottom one. Because the hole didn't fit both the two tall ones, so had to go a little bit smaller. And I'll just cheat a little bit. I'll do like this because it's not worth how much. 450. Half the time it's gone now, and I don't really know more. Well, then I'm gonna actually spend a little bit of time to do so I get the handle. Maybe I don't have time for too much details, but extrude long face normals. Alt set to see through. Shift select these two, extrude, L to select the length, and we'll move it in. Hold the control key to snap to that vertex. And now we'll just duplicate that one, scale on the Z axis, put that on there. And here we can put a little cool like display up here. Usually I have like a little digital board up here. to say the temperature and stuff like that. So we'll move it to black, and I guess we can put some... I'm gonna put some fake text here. So let's just do E to extrude. We'll make a green light here. And it's gonna be emissive, so we can actually look later on what it looks like in... when we've got the stuff. Should we do a red light as well? You have no idea about, like, if it's working or nothing, because it's like lit up in all sorts of different lights there. Should we see rendered? Ooh, okay. I don't know why it's so slow. Maybe I've got cycles or something. So L, select the link. And I'm gonna put another one here. We're gonna make a massive thing. So I'm gonna L to select all the links, and then let's Shift D to duplicate it, and space. You wouldn't have two like these, would you? Feels like a lot of stuff. No, you know what? I'll take that away. That wouldn't be there. It wouldn't be realistic, would it? So Shift and D to duplicate that. Put something else here in the corner. How am I doing for time? 3 minutes left approximately. So we'll go up to there. We'll put a sink here instead. So like screw that on, put it there, Control R. And you wouldn't really have the sink this far away from the cooker. Like, I'm not a kitchen planner now, so bear with me. Not here. Kangaroo with me instead, maybe. Height inset. We'll do two sinks. It's better to sink twice. That's how I always say. Well, I never said that before, but I said it now. Period. Individual audience. Space. I don't know. That should do it. And then we have to put a faucet. A tap. And should we go fancy? Yeah, we should do it. We'll make it. We bevel it. And then here, we'll just control right click to extrude it. And we'll do one of these things. E to extrude, S to scale, E to extrude. And I'll put one here as well. That's a massive thing. It wouldn't necessarily look like that at all. So I'll make a small one here. For the filtered water, that's also what we've got here. I'm not used to that either. You have to have a little small tap for filtered water. Should we put some... I'm like speaking half sentences here, but I'll do some drawers here. No, here we have to do doors instead. We can't have the drawers everywhere. That drive me... Draw your nuts. Draw your nuts. It wouldn't draw your nuts. That sounds even weird. I should just be quiet half the time. There we go. We'll put a kitchen table here then. So Shift Space G. I'm missing like appliances and stuff, so... I'm probably off on the proportions as well, but GZ, 0.8, roughly that height, I guess. No, it's too high. And we'll do kitchen legs here, Shift Space. Scale it down, scale it on the Z axis. Okay, scale it on the Y axis. That's fine. Scale, wow. Control key, snap it to there. Control key, snap it to there. Can't see it, but I'm doing it there anyway. And L to select the link. Alt Z so I can see through what I'm doing. G to move it, Shift Space, and then move it on that axis. L to select the length, Shift B to there, and then move it to there. Alt Z. We'll put a rug here as well. Okay, I'm gonna do this white actually, so we can see a bit of a difference here. Or I'm gonna do it black. I don't know what color to do. Shift Space. I think I'm gonna do a wood floor as well. We'll put a carpet here, so all the like when you drop all this crumbs and stuff, it's got somewhere to go. It's always good. So I'm gonna put L. I'm not gonna put L. I'm gonna put wood floor there instead. And okay, I'll make a percolator. We cannot live without coffee, I guess. So there, right click. We'll do circle with the loop tools add on. E to extrude. E to extrude. S to scale. Shift space G. We'll put the coffee pot here. E to extrude. S to scale. We need a kettle as well. So we have to get the things right. So Shift space, scale. We cannot have a wood percolator either. That would suck. It would look pretty cool, but it just would not work. So I to inset, E to extrude. So I have to recolor this now. We have to go at least for some sort of a gray. And then here, the coffee pot. I'll fill it half with coffee. So, oh, what? You're kidding me? What happened? I'm sure there was a minute left there. At least I got the coffee in. Okay. So I'm a bit rusty, apparently. It seems I'm a bit rusty. Need to practice a little bit more. Last week I got a few extra times in because I failed to record it. So this is a mini kitchen. Do you know what? Let's call it bonus time. So that this is the official one. Let's save it, Control S, and then I'm gonna save it as a just a little bonus kitchen. Kitchen bonus. This is gonna go up on my Patreon, of course, as well, so the tutorial here and up will be able to get this. Let's pretend we had a little bit more time to tinker. In that case, I would have probably changed this to like a glass color, and I would have changed to make sure that there's like, you know, the coffee sump. I don't know what it's called in this language, in English. But you'd have like a lid here, E to extrude, and then E to extrude this, scale on the x-axis, E to extrude, and then pull this in. You'd do something like that. You don't really, like, you just have to get the main shapes, I think, all right. And it cannot just hover in the air like this. This is something the AI would do. It would just not care about the fact that something needs to be attached sometimes. So I'd put it like that. Control R, maybe look up there. Now I've got like time to do look a bit fancy here. I'm not gonna care about the cord, but another thing you probably would have bought, okay, you cannot even lift this without the handle. So let's put here, we'll do Shift D to duplicate. No, should I? There, Shift E to duplicate it, scale it down, E to extrude, and then E to extrude. This is how I should have done the other thing at the same time, actually. Alt Z, E to extrude, and L to select the link, then go for like the dark in there. So at least you could grab the coffee there. You'd probably need a kettle as well. Shift D to duplicate, right click on that one, subdivide, do the circle, scale it down, E to extrude, E to extrude, E to extrude, S to scale, E to extrude, S to scale. E to extrude, S to scale, and you put like a little, maybe you'll just do E to extrude, S to scale on the Z axis, and E to extrude, scale, and here you can do period and go, or comma you can do, and do normals instead, because then you can still scale on the axis there, on the Y axis. Don't know why I'm saying that, because it's not a tutorial, but I like to share. Scale that down, and it doesn't look much like a kettle, but you could pretend it is. And then we'll put a handle here as well. Here I'm gonna do one of these just that goes, could grab it there, E to extrude, S to scale on the X axis, on the Y axis, we're in the normal mode here. And there we go, there's our kettle. Should we do it red, a red kettle so you can see it? Yep, it's not connected anywhere, safety reasons, so comma, global, and so I guess it's technically cheating what I'm doing now. So I think at least we've got that stuff sorted. We'll put a little runner on the table as well, make it nice. And what color? Well, I have to have a little special color there, so maybe that color. And then should we do? Let's have a look what the render, what did the render did we have? It was Eevee. How come it was so slow? I've got no light. So let's add a light. Let there be light, Shift A, light, and let's put a sun in here. Rotate the light, rotate, G, 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 G. Good game, G, G. And maybe we can put some lights in here as well. Should we put some neon lights? That's the last thing I'm gonna do. I'm technically cheating now, because this is not within the time frame, but never mind. So E to extrude, we'll go up to here. And then control plus, control minus, control plus. Just want that, and then we'll do some, going for a lot of dark here. We'll go for white walls then. Yeah, that's it. And I just wanted to put a little light here as well. So, can we put some crazy light here in the back? Sometimes in modern kitchens, right? You can put like something that glows in here. I wonder if I can do it with the emission. Shift space. And I don't think Eevee lights up the emission as much as Cycles does. So, but we'll try a little blue light there. Said rendered, no, but we can do we can add an area light here maybe. So we'll do Shift S, cursor to selected, Shift A, light, and then an area light. That's it. And then we can change the color of this one to the blue color. There we go. and then W, we'll have to move it down. I think it's actually right inside the face there, so we have to move it down. You could put some lights there. Should we put some fake lights in here? Area lights are nice. I like them. Shift space D. Put some. What? What am I doing? Shift D. Duplicate. There we go. Shift D to duplicate. That worked. All right, so not bad for 10 minutes, right on the dot. It was just like literally as the timer went out, I accidentally just fell over fixing that. And it's actually down to 2% as well. So that was a close call. I nearly failed this one, I'd say. But hey, I didn't. Just on the buzzer. That's what you call it, just on the buzzer. All right, folks, so there we have it. We have a buzzer finished kitchen here in 10 minutes. I hope you enjoyed this episode. It was a lot of fun and I have to keep practicing. So come back as well next week and maybe we'll do episode 103 then as well, who knows? And we should have a lot of fun and do some modeling now. Jump into the Discord server, join the weekly modeling challenge. Say hello to Arvid. He wants a lot more more submissions in there and we're gonna make sure that we get that to him, right? So get modeling, get practicing and see what the next week's theme is. And you can even squeeze the kitchen in if you have time because it's still a few days left until Monday when the theme changes. So thanks a lot everyone for joining. Give it a thumbs up if you like the video and don't forget to subscribe and I will see you again very shortly. So take care everyone and bye for now.